In this video, we go through the basic views of the Qt Design Studio. Here you can see the design mode when you first launch a new project. As you can see, the mode contains several different blocks, called views. At the center of the screen is the form editor. This is the screen containing the visual user interface and where you will create your designs. You can zoom it in and out with the magnifying glass icons at the top right corner of the view. At the top left corner is the navigator. You can see that there already is a rectangle and a text component. These are the components you see at the center of the screen in the form editor. The text Hello Demo Project is inside the rectangular shape. When you click on the text in the navigator, the text element on the form editor activates. This view helps you navigate within your project, which is why it is called a navigator. Next to the navigator is the Projects tab. This shows all the content of your project, including the user interface files, auto-generated QML files, imported images, and so on. The row called screen01.ui.qml is selected because it refers to the screen in the form editor that we currently have open. The form editor shows the visual user interface, and that's why the name contains the UI file name extension. At the bottom left corner is the Components tab where you can find the ready-made components and later your own components. Let's add a rectangular component to our design. Type rectangle to the search bar and drag the component to the scene in the form editor. In the navigator view, we can see that a new rectangle has been added there as well. On the right-hand side is the Properties tab. Here you can see the properties of the component that is currently selected. We can, for example, change the ID of the rectangle so that it is easier to recognize it from the navigator's list. The ID must always start with a lowercase letter. When you scroll down, you can change the rectangle's other properties, like fill and border colors, and border width. This is how you could start creating your design. In the next course, we will create a simple application by using the ready-made components. In the Components tab, you can find lots of different components. When you scroll down, you can find the Qt Quick Controls, which contain ready-made buttons, sliders, and much more.